True patriot love, in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free.
Hey, I guess we're probably going to be changing this speaker because I'm getting complaints that it's a little bit too quiet back there. So I'll make sure just everybody here. And well, I guess in the meantime, while Mark Lee would be next, he's Lee Harding, candidate from Swift Current. And we're happy to have him here.
I guess I'm the one you don't really need to hear. You can hear me now. When you need to hear the people later, then. Speaker, we hooked up. Yes, I am Lee. I live in Swift Current, and I'm running as the candidate in Cypress Hills Grasslands. I am known for a few different things. My great hair and fake eyebrows are neither of them, and I am very much unlike Justin Trudeau. I want to see this button across. We've got a wind that's going to.
How's that? Is that better?
Somewhat different. All right. It's got a little reverb there, I think.
Yep, we're doing a reverb.
Yeah. It's very much unlike the echo chamber, so that we can't have that. We're having some mainstream ideas that are not necessarily represented. Okay. So, as I said before, I'm known for a few different things. I interned with CBC. I interned with CTV as a reporter. I worked for Global. And later on, I became a spokesperson for the Canadian Taxpayers Federation. More taxes, less waste, more accountable government. And as I'm running as a candidate for the People's Party, I still very much believe in those things. As I knock on doors and listen to everyday people in my riding, they believe in the message of the PPC. Sometimes I will knock on the door and say, "What issues concern you?" Well, there's a lot of them offhand. I don't know really where to start. Just get rid of Trudeau. Okay, well, yeah. That's a good... You know, I think our carbon emissions are going to be a lot lower when he's not yapping as the Prime Minister. You said it.
We need carbon, though.
So, when I tell them we want to have less money going in equalization to Quebec and reform this whole system so it's not just a welfare system that sucks money from the western provinces and sends it elsewhere. Well, I agree with that, they'll tell me. That we also want to see taxpayer dollars not go to private corporations any longer. We work hard for our money and they should have to work to make money in the same way. No one's asking our permission to give money to Bombardier, to SNC-Lavalin, to Loblaws, to whoever. So let's stop that. Trudeau has sent money abroad. Heck, he can send $25 million on Twitter and just look like a really nice guy. But none of that came out of his pocket. And as many of you know, Margaret Thatcher said, the problem with socialism is eventually you run out of other people's money. So we want the money of Canadians to stay in Canadians' pockets, and when we show fiscal restraint, then we can talk about balanced budgets again, and we are the last party that has in its platform to balance the budget in this term. That is very, very important. And it's important because as our baby boomer generation heads into retirement, there's going to be increased costs in our social programs, in our health care, in our pensions, and we need to have people working to support that. And if we can't balance it now, it's going to be more difficult in the future. And so that's why I love what we are wanting to do with employment, with getting pipelines built, and Maxime Bernier is the one with the courage to say the same message in every part of the country and to change minds. This is the leader, this is the platform, this is what we have been waiting for. So. I remember watching an episode of Family Feud, and don't worry, my comments will end soon. This is not a really long aside. But the question Steve Harvey was asking, if you threw a party and nobody showed up, what would you do? The guy just said, I guess they cancel it. He started laughing. I guess some people said the same thing. You know, Max showed a tremendous amount of courage when he said, we need to forward these ideas. And he threw a party, not knowing who would come. But he knew what he believed in because these are the things that he has always believed in and is always going to believe in. And that's why it's so attractive to Canadians. Woo. This party is not about us, it's about you. So we're throwing a party. You are the people. And you know what a party is like? The more people there are, the greater the party it is. Thanks for coming today. Let's make our party greater than it's ever been.